रैंडम वेरिएबल। A continuous random variable capital X is said to follow normal distribution continuous random variable capital X is said to follow normal distribution with mean mu and variance sigma squared if the PDF of capital X if the PDF of the random variable capital X is of the form fx is equal to 1 by root over 2 pi sigma e to the power minus x minus mu whole squared by 2 sigma squared minus infinity less than x less than infinity small x. So this is the probability density function. If fx is equal to 1 by root over 2 pi sigma e to the power minus x minus mu divided by x minus mu squared by 2 sigma squared whenever x lies between minus infinity to infinity, then x will follow normal distribution. Here two parameters of the distribution are mu and sigma, or sometimes sigma squared. Okay, so sometimes this can be written as x is following normal mu sigma squared distribution. X is following normal mu sigma squared distribution, that is x is equal to normal mu sigma squared. That is mean is mu and standard deviation is sigma squared. But in some books you may find different notation. X is normal mu sigma, sometimes it may given. In that case mu is the mean and sigma, if given sigma, then that is the standard deviation.
Okay.
Now, if we plot the graph of normal distribution, x axis, and here this is the point mu, okay, and it is symmetric about x equal to mu. Okay. So that's the graph of normal distribution with mean mu and variance sigma squared. Now we'll define another kind of normal distribution, that is standard normal distribution. Standard normal distribution. So what is standard normal distribution? A random variable capital X, obviously continuous, a continuous random variable capital X is said to follow standard normal distribution if the PDF of X is given by I'm writing that PDF as phi x that will be 1 by root over 2 pi e to the power minus x squared by 2 minus infinity less than x less than infinity. So that the standard normal distribution. Now if we compare with this structure, the difference, sigma takes the value 1 and mu is taking the value 0. So this standard normal distribution is sometimes known as normal 0-1 distribution. Normal 0-1 distribution means mean of the distribution is 0 and variance or standard deviation of the distribution is 1. So sometimes it's written as X is following normal 0-1 distribution. That is mean of the normal standard normal distribution is 0 and variance of the standard normal distribution is 1. Variance of the standard normal distribution is 1. So this is the structure of standard normal distribution. Now how from this structure we can get this structure? So that is a transformation. So conversion of any normal random variable to standard normal random variable. So here we'll see the conversion. Let capital X follows normal distribution with mean mu and variance sigma squared. So you're assuming that the random variable capital X is following normal distribution with mean mu and variance sigma squared. Now let us make take define another random variable. Suppose we are defining z is equal to the original random variable, that is the normal random variable x, minus mean of that random variable divided by the standard deviation of that random variable. So you are defining another random variable z is equal to x minus mu divided by sigma. What is x? X is a normal random variable, mu is the mean of the random variable, and sigma is the standard deviation of the random variable. So in that case, z will follow. So if we define z is equal to x minus mu divided by sigma, then z follows standard normal distribution. Then z will follow standard normal distribution. Okay, so how to standardize a random normal random variable? The random variable itself, that is x minus mean of the random variable divided by the standard deviation of the random variable. So the new random variable z so defined will follow standard normal distribution. So in that case, what will happen? That is, expectation of z, that is mean of the distribution, that will become zero, and variance of z, this will be 1. Variance of z will be 1. Today we are not going to solve any problem related to normal distribution, standard normal distribution. Since for that we need a table, in the next class I will share the table with you, and will also discuss how to find values from that table.
is one-dimensional distribution. We'll solve some problem related to normal distribution later. Now, today we'll start higher order random variable, that is two-dimensional, two or more dimensional random variable. Two-dimensional random variable. With two-dimensional random variable. Two-dimensional random variable. What is two-dimensional random variable? Suppose we want to identify two characteristics of a sample. Okay. For example, suppose we want to study the height and weight of all the students of SMIT. Okay. So here we are interested in two characteristics of a sample. Suppose we are randomly selecting a student from SMIT. So we are interested in identifying two characteristics of that sample. One is height, another is weight. Since we want to identify two characteristics of the sample, we need to define two random variables. Okay, we need to define two random variables. Suppose we want to identify three characteristics, that is height, weight, and say height, weight, and say BMI. Okay. Then we need to identify, we need three random variables. So let us write the definition. Let capital S be the sample space associated with a random experiment capital E. So let us define, let X is equal to XS, Y is equal to YS, small s, be two functions each assigning a real number to each outcome small s
belongs to capital X, then X comma Y, then X comma Y is called a two-dimensional then X comma Y is called a two-dimensional random variable. Now, so what is two-dimensional random variable? So that's the sample space capital S. We are taking a sample. So X is a function which takes the sample space, takes the point smallest from the sample space and assign that point to a real number XS. Simultaneously, Y is taking the same random variable and assigning that to another real number YS. So here X comma Y is a two-dimensional random variable. Now, if possible values of X comma Y are finite or countably infinite, then X comma Y is called a two-dimensional discrete random variable. If the possible values of X comma Y is finite or countably infinite, if the possible values of X comma Y is finite or countably infinite, X comma Y is called a two-dimensional discrete random variable. X comma Y is called a two-dimensional discrete random variable. Now, when X comma Y is a two-dimensional, so in this case, the possible values of, that is, when X comma Y is a two-dimensional discrete random variable, in this case, the possible values of X comma Y may be expressed as xi comma yj xi comma yj I takes the value 1, 2, 3. And so on, and J takes the value 1, 2, 3, so on.
So if x comma y is a discrete random variable, then the possible values of x comma y can be listed at xi comma yj. I takes the value 0, 1 to up to m and so on. J takes the value 1 through n up to so on. Okay.
Now, let us define in discrete case. Let us define probability function. So, if x comma y is a two-dimensional discrete random variable, if x comma y is a two-dimensional discrete random variable such that probability that x is taking the value xi together with y is taking the value yj, this is equal to p of I comma j, x is taking the value xi together y is taking the value yj, is p of I comma j, then p of, or this sometimes can be written as or, small p xi comma yj, sometimes it can also be written in this way, that is capital X is taking the value small xi and capital Y is taking the value small yj, then Pij or Pxi comma yj is called probability mass function. Probability mass function or probability function of x comma y provided the following conditions are satisfied. Following conditions satisfied. Number one, P of xi comma yj or P of I comma j is greater than or equal to 0 for all I and j, for all I comma j, and number 2, summation over I, summation over j, p of xi comma yj, or p of ij, this equal to 1.
So these are the two conditions, so that p xi comma yj is the probability mass function of a discrete two-dimensional discrete random variable x comma y. So each probability must be greater than or equal to 0, and sum of all the probability is equal to 1. Sum of all the probability is equal to 1. So these are the two criteria or two conditions. So let us try to solve a problem. So the problem I'm considering here is the following. Three balls are drawn at random. Without replacement, without replacement from a box containing two white two white, comma three red, and four black balls. Now, the random variables are defined in this way. If capital X denotes the number of white balls, number of white balls drawn and k
capital Y denotes the number of red balls drawn. Number of red balls drawn, comma, find the probability distribution of X, comma, Y. Find the probability distribution find the probability distribution of X, Y. Now, X, how we have defined X? X denotes the number of white balls drawn. So how many white balls are there? Two white balls are there. So we may not draw any white ball. We may draw only white, one white ball or two white ball, but not more than two. So the possible values of X are 0, 1 and 2. So the possible values of X are, here we are writing the solution. Possible values of X are 0, 1 and 2, and possible values so what will be the possible values of Y? Y is the number of red balls drawn, that is 0, 1, 2 and 3. Possible values of Y are 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so this we are getting the possible values of X and possible values of Y. Now let us try to find the probabilities. Probability X is taking the value 0, together is Y is taking the value 0. So probability X is taking the value, that is, we are not drawing any white ball. Y is taking the value 0. Also, we are not drawing any red ball. So, all the balls drawn must be black. Okay. So, how many total numbers of balls are there? 2, 5 plus 4, that is 9. So from 9 balls, we are selecting 3 balls. So the total number of points in the event space will be 9C3. And we are selecting 3 balls in such a way that in that selected 3 ball, there is no red ball, there is no white ball. That is, all the balls are black. So what we will get? 4C3. 4C3 by 9C3. If we simplify that, it will be 1 by 21. Okay. Next, we need to find probability X is equal to 0 together with Y is equal to 1. Probability X equal to 0, Y is equal to 1. So the total number of points in the event space is 9C3. Now we are selecting 3 ball in such a way that there is no white ball, there is one red ball. So the remaining balls must be black. So one red ball. So how many red balls are there? 3 red balls are there. 3 say 1 together with that, 2 balls are black. 4C2. So if we simplify, it will be 3 by 14. Next, probability
x equal to 0, y is equal to 2.
So probability x equal to 0, y is equal to 2, nc3, there is no white ball, two red balls, that is 3c2 together with, so the remaining ball must be black ball, 4c1, so it's coming to be 1 by 84. In probability x is equal to 0, y is equal to 3, probability x is equal to 0, y is equal to 3, what are the possible values of y? 0, 1, 2 and 3. Already x is equal to 0, y is equal to 3, so there is no white ball, 3 red balls, that is 3c3, since all the balls are red, there is no white ball, there is no black ball, 9c3, so 3c3 divided by 9c3, that will be 1 by 84. I made a mistake. X is equal to 0, y is equal to 2. That is not 1 by 84. This value is coming to be 1 by 7. Next, the possibilities are probability x is equal to 1, y is equal to 0. Probability x is equal to 1, y is equal to 0. So what will be probability x is equal to 1, y is equal to 0? 9c3, one white ball, that is 2c1, into, there is no red ball, so all the remaining balls must be black, so 4c2. So ultimately we land up with 1 by 7 if we simplify. Now probability x is equal to 1, y is equal to, probability x is equal to 1, y is equal to 1, so I will get 9c3, one white ball, 2c1 together with one red ball, that is 3c1, and the remaining ball must be black ball, 4C1. So it's coming to be 2 by 7. Probability x is equal to 1, y is equal to 2. So one white ball, that is 2C1, into two red balls, 3C2, since we have selected three balls, there is no black ball, so it's coming to be 1 by 14. Now probability x is equal to 1, y is equal to 3. Now x is equal to 1, y is equal to 3, this is not possible since the game is to select three balls. Now if we are one white ball and three red balls are there, that is we are selecting four balls, that is not possible. Okay, so that is impossible event. So probability of impossible event is 0. Now probability x is equal to 2, y is equal to 0. Now probability x equal to 2, y is equal to 2c2 into, that is, there is no red ball, so one ball must be black, 9c3. So x is equal to 2, y is equal to 0, it's coming to be 1 by 21. Now probability x is equal to 2, y is equal to 1, probability x equal to 2, y is equal to 1, it's coming 9c3, 2c2 into
3C1. So it's coming 1 by 28. Now probability x is equal to 2, y is equal to 2, that is impossible even since 4 balls, but the game is to select 3 balls. And probability x is equal to 2, y is equal to 3, this is also 0. Okay, so this we are getting. Now we can write this in a tabular form in this fashion, x, y, so in this direction I am writing x, 0, 1, 2. In this direction, I'm writing y, 0, 1, 2, 3. Now write the corresponding probabilities. So, x equal to 0, y is equal to 0. X equal to 0, y is equal to 0. You have calculated that is 1 by 21. X is equal to 1, y is equal to... Okay, let me write column wise. X equal to 0, y is equal to 1. Second is x equal to 0, y is equal to 1, that is 3 by 14. Now x equal to 0, y is equal to 2, x equal to 0, y is equal to 2 is 1 by 7. X equal to 2, y is equal to 3, that is 1 by 84. Then x is equal to 1, y is equal to 0, x is equal to 1, y is equal to 0, it's 1 by 7. X equal to 1, y is equal to 1, x equal to 1, y is equal to 1, it's coming 2 by 7. Now x is equal to 1, y is equal to 2, 1 by 14. X is equal to 1, y is equal to 3, that is 0. Now x is equal to 2, y is equal to 0, that is 1 by 21. X is equal to 2, y is equal to 0, 1 by 28, 0, 0. Okay. So that's the probability distribution. You can check, see, each probability is greater than or equal to 0, and if we sum up all these probabilities, that sum will be 1. You can check that. So this is how to write the probability distribution in case of two-dimensional discrete random variable. So